Round the throne. body that will worship. The Lord desires a freedom in the spirit. Come on, he knows your faults. He knows everything that you do before you're going to do it. But don't let that be a hindrance as to why you don't give God your best. Don't let that be a hindrance why you don't think that you can't come before God and give him your worship and give him your praise. He knows you. Said before you were born in your mother's womb, I knew you. He created you to worship. We were created to worship. We were created to give him our best.
Worship him. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Oh, yes. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. He's worthy. He's worthy. Glory. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy on this Pentecost Sunday. Pentecost is a time of celebration. Pentecost is the time of the outpouring. He's worthy, he's worthy. He's worthy, he's worthy. He's worthy, he's worthy. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. He's worthy. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, Come on, come on, come on. We can do better than that. Come on. Come on, we can do better than that. 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 We can do better than that. Yeah, 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 yeah. We said it earlier. We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name of Jesus. Do I have any witnesses in here? Yes, God. We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name of Jesus. 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 We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name of Jesus. Oh, glory, glory. It's in the name of Jesus. We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name of Jesus. Do I have any witnesses in here? It's in the name of Jesus. Power to walk right. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. It's in the name of Jesus. It's in the name of Jesus. Power to walk right. Power to talk right. Power to live right. Holy Ghost power. Holy Ghost power. 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 I'm talking about the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about Pentecost. I'm talking about an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about the Holy Ghost. I dare you to shout Holy Ghost. I dare you to shout Holy Ghost. I dare you to shout Holy Ghost. Power. 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 Yes, Lord. 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 Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, praise team. Thank you. Glory. 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 Glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Woo. I dare to shout Pentecost. I'm not talking about a denomination. I'm talking about an outpouring of the Spirit. Joel even picked it up that said, in the last days, I'm going to pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And I come to tell you this morning that we are in revival. We are in the last revival. We are in outpouring, where the Lord is pouring out his Spirit upon all flesh. And it's happening right now. It's happening right now. It's happening. It's happening right now. It's happening in the body of Christ. An outpouring of the Spirit. And the next thing that we're about to experience like never before are miracles, signs, and wonders. I'm talking about miracles. I'm talking about the beyond what we've seen in the Bible, because he said, greater works than these shall we do. I'm talking about when folks come in here sick and walk out healed. I'm talking about the eyes being open to the blind. I'm talking about the ears being open to the deaf. I'm talking about limbs growing back. I'm talking about miracles. Hallelujah. Miracles. Glory, 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 glory. Glory. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Glory. Hallelujah. We're getting ready. We want to welcome you to the New Life Experience. Hallelujah. We can get ready before we bring our dance ministry. Amen. We're going to get ready for the New Life School of Theology as we transition. As we transition. Hallelujah. As we transition.
Friends, Dr. Andy C. Luter here, president of the New Life School of Theology of Cape Coral, Florida. Listen, friends, I am so excited about introducing to you the newest extension campus to our family of schools around the country. That's right. I want to welcome the Macon, Georgia campus of the New Life School of Theology to our family of schools. A special shout out to Overseer Eric Bell, who is our school liaison there in Macon, Georgia. And I am so happy to welcome this campus to our program. The New Life School of Theology is an accredited school that is authorized and acknowledged by the Department of Education for the state of Florida. And as such, we are authorized to extend and deliver religious degrees to individuals who complete a specified curriculum. We are offering to the Macon campus a certificate in sacred theology. This is a 10-course curriculum. It is conducted over 5 quarters. And there are 2 courses that's completed every quarter for a total of 10 courses for the completion of the program. That's right. You don't have to leave. You can stay right there in your homes. The coursework is delivered to you virtually. And we meet for a 2-day period, a total of 4 hours every quarter. Now, our next upcoming quarter is the spring quarter of 2021. We will be meeting on Friday, June the 4th at 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. And then we'll be meeting again on Saturday. That would be the 5th of June from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. The courses that we will be sharing during this spring quarter include the disciples of Jesus. And this is more than a mere Bible study. We actually look at all of the disciples of Jesus. We look at when they were born, where they grew up, how they met Jesus, their interaction with Jesus, but perhaps more importantly, where did they go once Jesus returned to his heavenly Father? Where did they plant churches and ministry? How did they die? What were the circumstances of their death? And what symbols and emblems now remain even today that represents these disciples? I know you're probably familiar with the ministry of Paul or the ministry of Peter, but how about Benjamin and Nathaniel and James and John and the other disciples that were a part of Jesus's earthly ministry? We go through that in great detail. And so we'll be doing that course on Friday, the 4th of June for a 2-hour period. And then we're coming back on Saturday for another 2 hours, and we're looking at African-American sacred music. Now, this is a robust study of sacred song in the faith community of African-Americans. We'll begin with slave songs, and then we'll look at spirituals. We'll look at anthems and hymns. We'll look at traditional gospel. We'll also look at modern gospel and contemporary gospel. We'll discuss in great detail the interaction between gospel music and blues, jazz, and other genres of music that are highly dependent upon the 5-note pentatonic scale that began in the African American community. Listen, you don't want to miss that. So we are real excited about this spring quarter again. It will take place on June the 4th, June the 5th, that's a Friday night, and a Saturday. And you will be a part of the New Life School of Theology Macon campus. Again, these courses lead to a certificate in sacred theology, which will be conferred at the completion of 10 courses. So listen, take action right now. Make contact with Overseer Bell and prepare to be a part of this next educational experience. Again, I'm Dr. Andy C. Luter, and on the behalf of the New Life School of Theology, let me welcome you, Macon, Georgia, to our family, to our studies, to our library, to our academic and scholarly resources. And it is our hope and our prayer that what we share with you will greatly impact your life. This school is for laity, it's for clergy, it's for people who have a genuine appetite and interest in the things of God. That's right, the New Life School of Theology Macon campus. God bless.
Amen, amen. We want you to make sure, those of you that if you have not registered, make sure you go to Eventbrite. The time is coming real close, so we want to make sure that you go to Eventbrite and register. It's only $25. It's only $25. I'm telling you, it's worth investing into yourself. Amen. So we want you all to make sure that you go to Eventbrite and register. It's not just for clergy. It's for any and everyone. So I encourage you to go today, Eventbrite.com, and type in New Life School of Theology. And make sure that you register, because I'm telling you, it's going to bless you real good. Now, we ask that, you know, everyone, we're still, even though I know our governor has said that we don't have to, but I'm still honoring the CDC guidelines. So we ask everyone that is not up, that you make sure you keep your mask on as we are continuing to observe the CDC guidelines. And we already know we're doing social distancing. Amen. We're continuing to do that. So make sure that you keep your mask on. We know praise team just left out from up here. So, but they have theirs on while they're seated in the congregation. Again, I thank God for you all. We're going to be blessed this morning before we go into the word on this Pentecost Sunday. Amen. Our fine arts ministry going to come now, and they're going to bless us real good. So let's receive now New Life International Ministries, Fine Arts Ministry. Let's give them a hand clap of praise as they come. Hallelujah.
about him. You died for me. And you set me free. Come on, Tasha, help me see. My brokenness,
I am yours.
My pain, I give it all to you, Jesus. Was blind, but now I see.
Blind, but now I see. And you never,
thank you, God. You never gave
you
up
never
on me.
My beautiful soul.
There is nobody like Jesus. There is nobody like Jesus. Can we identify with that? Is there anybody else in here that can testify? There's nobody like Jesus. There's nobody like Jesus. We thank God.
If he walked into the room,
for allowing us to see
what would you do?
Jubilee, Pentecost Sunday.
If he walked into the room,
because we know
what?
This time last year, it was somewhat different. Amen. So we're just excited, amen, to be back together to see you. Thank God for Lady Bell. Amen. We're in a very interesting time. In the realm of the spirit, for what God is doing in the earth realm, it is very interesting. I say this often whenever we talk about mass outpourings or mass revivals. We see it as a New Testament church. The first happened on the day of Pentecost when the Spirit was released to the church in its entirety, whether Jew or Gentile. Because before Pentecost, it was only for the Jews. Then after Pentecost on that particular day, the Spirit was released for the Gentiles as well. Now you do understand that we were considered as Gentiles. All non-Jews were considered as Gentiles. Now, theologically, as we know this, that's why I can't understand. If all of us are Gentiles, what gives us the right to look down on each other? We can't. Because we were all Gentiles. So now, because of the love of Christ, now we have the same right as a Jew. We have the same right, the same privileges. We fall under the Abrahamic covenant. We all of those blessings that was limited to one group now is open for everyone. That includes all of us. So this is why it is so important. So the first mass outpouring of revival was on the day of Pentecost. There was another going through the Crusade era, the Crusade period. There was another outpouring. And the third was, how many of y'all heard of Azusa, the Azusa Street revival, the Azusa Street? That was the third outpouring where there was a mass revival. And now there's the fourth. Everybody say fourth. We are now experiencing, and it has not hit to the fullness that it's going to. We are now part of the fourth mass outpouring to hit the earth realm. This is why anytime, let me say this to you, anytime you want to gauge what's happening in the fulfillment of the word, don't pay attention to what's going on here in the United States. Watch over there with Israel. Okay, let me say it again. Anytime you want to see, you want to kind of gauge what's happening, don't necessarily focus on what's going on here in the United States. Look what's going on over in Israel. Because you got to understand, when the Bible was written, it wasn't written for, there was no United States, but there was an Israel and Palestinians. And Mesopotamia, which is Saudi Arabia, Turkey, Iran, Iraq, that whole region. So when you want to gauge to see what's happening, start watching the events that's happening in Israel. Because see, what a lot of people don't know, you know, and I'm gonna just give you a little rapture nuggets. You know, there was a man that was transcended into heaven called Elijah, who never saw death. Okay, now I'm gonna show y'all something. Let me show y'all really what's going on, Elizabeth. Watch this. We read the story over there in Kings about Elijah being transfigured, the chariot coming and getting him and him going back, and Elijah seeing him going up. He was transfigured into the earth. Well, in Revelation, Elijah comes back on earth physically. Elijah comes back on earth physically and walks the earth and will be killed in the streets of Israel. Watch this. Let me show y'all how close we are. The Jews in Israel are expecting a manifestation of Elijah at any moment. Okay, y'all missed that. The Jews, right now, they are expecting a manifestation of Elijah at any moment to walk the streets of Jerusalem. This is what's supposed to happen as for the second coming of Christ. Elijah will come first, almost like a John the Baptist. He's gonna come, he's gonna get slaughtered in the streets. Well, they're looking for, they're literally, the scribes that are there now are really, in a moment, just looking for a manifestation of Elijah. This is why, let me show you something. So you gotta understand to be able to tie in what's happening in the natural, in the spirit. This is why there is a, all of a sudden, now like never before, you seeing prophet this and prophetess that. There's a rise of prophets and prophetess. Because Elijah, as they're expecting him, that particular realm is open. The prophet, prophetess. Now, this is why you got to be careful. I'm trying to help you all. You got to be careful because the satanic kingdom or the spirit of Antichrist is also on the rise. Everything that the kingdom of God has manifested, the Antichrist is duplicating it. And many are being deceived because it looks real. But guess what? If you notice something, there's a denying of the power, form of godliness. But many people are denying the power there. What do I mean? Oh, it don't take all that. It don't take all of that. And now, this is what you got to be careful of. Also, I hear people say, oh, I believe in God. Well, let me tell you something. There are many gods. But do you believe in Jesus? Because the Bible says that at the name of Jesus, every knee is going to bow. And every tongue is going to confess that he is Lord. There are many gods. There are many. That's why, you know, people, and you got to be careful now. Let me say this too, because this is just filling my spirit. Be careful when folks say, I'm praying for you. Be careful. You don't know what they're praying or who they praying to. There's a lot going on. There's a lot going on in the spirit. This is why this morning on this Pentecost Sunday, because I was like, Lord, what do you have to say? What you got to say? What do you have to say to your church on this particular? Now we know that this is a time set aside for celebration of Pentecost Sunday. There are many theological debates whether or not it, you know, the winter and the fall, the spring. I get into all that, but this is a time that's been set globally for. This festival, this was a festival. When you go in historically, when you look at Pentecost, what was going on, they were all, had all come to Jerusalem. This is a festival. This was a jubilee. Amen. So this is why there was a whole bunch of folk that was there at that particular time. And there was 120 in what we call the upper room, where Jesus told the disciples, now make sure y'all go in the upper room and you're going to be endowed with power. So that leads us this morning. We're going to talk a little bit. I want to talk to y'all something that many people are not talking about nor preaching about in today's society. We're going to talk about the Holy Ghost. I ain't talking about you're going to get rich quick. I'm not talking about you're going to, no. To this morning, we're going to talk about, everybody say, the Holy Ghost. Now, we used to hear preaching about the Holy Ghost a lot when we were younger, growing up, because, you know, now it's kind of, you know, kind of dwindled away because, you know, we want to, you know, deal with other things. But the Lord told me, he said, son, listen, this is what I need for you to do. I need for you to talk about the Holy Ghost, and I'm going to unveil and reveal some things to you concerning the Holy Ghost, because now, like never before, do we need to preach and teach about the Holy, everybody say the Holy Ghost. So now let's look this morning. We're going to walk a little bit. Let's go to the Gospel according to John. The Gospel according to John. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Gospel according to John. John chapter 14, verses 16, 17, and verse 26. Then we're going to jump over to Acts of the Apostle. John chapter 14, I'm in an amplified version. John chapter 14, verses 16, 17, and 26. Watch this. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper, comforter, advocate, intercessor, counselor, strengthener, standby to be with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world, catch this, whom the world cannot receive and take to its heart, because it does not see him. That's how it is. I can't see him, so I don't believe it. You see that going on now? I can't see him, so I don't believe it. Uh-huh. Or know him. But you are supposed to know him, because he, the Holy Spirit, remains with you continually and will be in you. But verse 26, but the helper, comforter, advocate, intercessor, counselor, strengthener, standby, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, in my place, to represent me and act on my behalf, he will teach you all things, and he will help you remember everything I have told you. Let's jump over to Acts chapter 1, verse 8. But you will receive power and ability when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And you will be my witnesses to tell people about me. To tell people about me. To tell people about me. To tell people about the Holy Ghost. To tell people about Jesus. What are we preaching now if it ain't uplifting Jesus? Right. Both in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, and even to the ends of the earth. Finally, jump over one chapter to chapter 2 of Acts, verses 1 through 4. When the day of Pentecost had come, They were all together. They were all together. Ask your neighbor, where are you? They were all together in one place. And suddenly a sound came from heaven like a rushing violent wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. There appeared to them tongues resembling fire, which were being distributed among them. And they rested on each of them as each person received the Holy Spirit. And they were all filled, that is, diffused throughout their being with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in other tongues, different languages, as the Spirit was giving them the ability to speak out clearly and appropriately. This morning, we're going to talk about the Holy Ghost. Beloved, I laid before God. I know I went to Webster and I went to different my study material that I use, and I looked up the term Holy Ghost. I wanted to know theologically, what does the term mean? And in my doing so, watch this. The Holy Spirit told me, close that book. He said, close that book. Let me tell you who I am. Whew. He said, let me tell you who I am. Raven, and this is what he told me. I am the spirit of the all-powerful God sent to dwell in you to make you like me. All-powerful. Let me say that again. This is what he told me. He said, shut your book and lay here prostrate before me and let me tell you who I am. He said, and I began to start typing and writing, because I'm like, okay, you're talking fast. He said, you better keep up. Watch this. He said, I am the spirit of the all-powerful God sent to dwell in you to make you like me. All powerful. I come to tell you, we're supposed to be all powerful like God. He said, I sent myself to come and not just dwell upon you, but to dwell in you. What's happening now today is many people are jumping in and out the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is not dwelling in them, it's merely dwelling upon them. And God said here, I want to get on the inside of you, because when I get on the inside of you, that's when power is released in you. That's when true change happens, is when you let me get on the in. I wish somebody say, get in me, Holy Ghost, get in me. I want the fullness, not just upon me, but in me. That means it becomes a part of your every being. When you inhale and exhale, it's the Holy Ghost. When you think, every thought is the Holy Ghost. When your heart beats, it's the Holy Ghost. When your lungs operate, it's the Holy Ghost. When all of your body organs operate, it's the Holy Ghost. It'll be no more us, but it'll be all. And watch this. And then he just told me, and that which is on the inside of you will manifest on the outside of you. Holy Ghost. Now, let me go into this, because this is so that challenges every last one of us, me as overseer, you as leader, you as lay member. God, fill us with the fullness of the Holy Ghost, because it's just like pouring water in a glass. There's a glass, it's called capacity. And then halfway is half capacity, and the rest is filled with air. Lord, we don't want no more air. We want the totality
totality of the Holy Ghost. So when you look in that vessel, you won't see no air. You won't see no flesh. When you look in that vessel, you will see the totality, the fullness of the Holy Ghost, so that we can do the exceedingly abundantly above, so that we can do greater miracles. Because guess what? We are, as we're talking about miracles, signs, and wonders, but there's a place that we've got to be in the Holy Ghost to operate on that, in that dimension, to operate in that realm, to be talking about healing the sick. Me personally, I'm gonna tell y'all something. I know where mine is. The Lord has gifted me with the gift of miracles. And my meditation here lately is, Lord, get me back into that place where you perform the miracles through me. I never forget, there was a young lady down in Perry, Georgia. We used to run tent revivals. And the Lord had been dealing with me on this. We used to run tent revivals. For one year, this was around 1997, 98, we ran a tent revival for an entire month. Every week we were in a different side of Perry. And I never forget, this particular day, the Holy Ghost had me fast. He said, don't you eat nothing. I'm like, huh? He said, don't you eat nothing. I don't want you to eat. I just want you to drink water. I said, okay. And I never forget the sermonic word that he gave me. I dealt with the woman that was caught in the act of adultery. And as Jesus was writing in the sand, he had me to deal with what was I writing in the sand? What was I writing in the dirt? And there was a young lady, and I'll never forget, the tent was packed. There was a young girl. She was around 13, 14 years old. Everybody knew her in the community. It was over in Smith Heights. I never forget this. And they rolled her in a wheelchair. I never forget, they rolled her in a wheelchair. She had never walked. Her family was there. Everybody knew her from that community. She had never walked before in her life. The doctors that said she would never walk before. And the Holy Ghost told me, and I was doing an illustration. I was sitting down in the sawdust and I was writing, just like doing an illustration of Jesus writing in the dirt, writing in the dirt. And the Holy Ghost said, stand up. And I stood up. He said, now call this girl forth. And I said, y'all bring her forth. And he told me, I never forget that. He said, pull her out of that wheelchair. And I said, huh? He said, I said, pull her out of that wheelchair. I'm going to perform a miracle through you. This is the gift I've given you, son. I said, what? I was obedient. I pulled her up out of the wheelchair. This girl stood and began to walk. Her legs literally straightened out. Her feet turned, they were like this, and they literally turned correctly. Strength went in her feet, and when she stood, people started passing out. They had to call the ambulance because literally people were passing out. All over, people were passing out all over the tent because they knew that this girl had never walked before. And God told me then, I've given you the gift of miracles. So me personally, Eric Leonard Bell, my prayer this last week has been, God, take me back to the place where miracles were being performed through your vessel. And he told me, he said, if you want that to happen, you've got to, watch this, you've got to allow me, hear me, I'm telling to me, but this is for you all, to fill you with capacity. The Holy Ghost where Eric Bell is no more, and it's all of me. If we're gonna operate to the fullness of the capacity of what God has sanctioned us to do, we have to die, and the Holy Ghost has to live. Come, everybody say completely. In us. Because Because I said, God, he said, because I'm moving in that dimension again where miracles are going to happen right here in New Life. He said, but I've given you the gift. Now you just got to tap back into it. So I'm like, when I say Eric Bell, I'm like, God, kill the fear, kill the doubt. Because see, it can't be no doubt operating in the Holy Ghost. So I'm praying, Lord, kill the doubt, kill the fear, kill, Lord, I don't want to get up there and look like a fool. He said, have I ever made you look like a fool? He said, who do you think I am? I come to tell somebody who's struggling in their gift, who's struggling whether or not they're going to be accepted, because this ain't on script, who's struggling whether or not they're going to be accepted, who's struggling with their gift. God told me to tell you right now, listen, stop struggling with it and start flowing in it, and let me do the thing that I want to do in you, not through you, but first in you. Holy Ghost. Now let me drop these couple of things on you about the Holy Ghost. Hear me. This is what the Lord gave me. The Holy Ghost isn't an it. It's an I. A lot of times we reference the Holy Ghost as it. He's, watch this. The Lord told me, when you call the Holy Ghost an it, you insult me. When you call the Holy Ghost an it, you insult me. He said, because I'm not a it. I am a he. I is a personal pronoun. He said, it is I. I'm not a it like I'm a thing or animal. He said, I am he. He said, the Holy Ghost is not, first of all, you got to get your vocabulary right. Stop referencing the Holy Ghost as an it. It is an I, it is a he. He said, when you take on personal pronouns, a personal pronoun replaces a noun. In other words, it takes the place of it. And when you refer to it, to the Holy Ghost as an it, you take away the personal side of it and you put it out there. But when you affirm and receive it as a he or an I, he said, now you take ownership. So he said, first of all, you got to change your vocabulary. The Holy Ghost isn't an it, but it's an I. Not only that, I know we hear this, but do we really get the totality of this next one? He told me, he said, the Holy Ghost is your power. It's your power. Many of us are trying to do it ourselves. And he said, you cannot do it yourself. He said, listen, I'm tired of fighting with you. He said, I'm tired of fighting with you. Watch this. Oh, God, he just dropped this on me. Your warfare is not between you and the devil now. Your warfare is between me and you. Because now you're fighting against me. Many of you, watch this. God said, I've given you gifts. I've chosen you. And you're fighting what you're supposed to be doing in the kingdom. You like, I don't feel worthy. I don't think that I'm ready for that. I don't think that's me. Many of you are fighting the Holy Ghost. And you think the warfare is with the devil. The warfare is not with the devil. The warfare is between you and the Holy Ghost. Because the Holy Ghost said, I'm raising you up. And you saying, I want to sit down. And when you do this, you try to operate on your own when you get ready. He said, nope. I'm your power. The Holy Ghost is your power. I can't lay hands on you and recover, you know, without the power of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is the one that makes everything operate. It is your source. The Holy Ghost is just like Georgia Power. I can go stick a plug in the wall. But if Georgia Power hadn't turned the switch on, I can put a plug in the wall all day and nothing will happen. The problem is why nothing is happening is because we're trying to stick a plug in a powerless socket. The Holy Ghost. Now this is interesting that he gave me in my time of laying. Now this next one, Lynn, is very interesting. Are you hearing me? The Holy Ghost said this. Put up point number 3. I want y'all to read this together. 1, 2, 3, read. Without the Holy Ghost, you have no chance. You ain't gonna win. In your natural, you are not strong enough to defeat the devil. You will never win battles and wars on your own. Without the Holy Ghost, you have no chance. Now this ain't we ain't gonna run our hoop last week. We ain't gonna run today. But I've got to give you this word. What am I saying here? The problem is many of us are having problems because we are trying to operate without the Holy Ghost. And he said, without the Holy Ghost, you have no chance. You trying to use your own logic, your own intellect. Watch this. You're trying to put in place what you have learned to make things work. And he's saying this. And see, when you put your logic in, that's when your mind goes into warfare. Because when you put your logic in and it doesn't work, then you start tripping in your head. Oh, I'm talking to somebody here. I'm talking to somebody. Why? Because, watch this, your logic is enmity against the Holy Ghost. Because your logic is based upon your experiences, whether it was positive and or negative. And a lot of our positive experiences were still negative because a lot of our positive experiences was based upon dysfunction that we didn't know was operating. Dysfunction has become normal. Oh, see, y'all don't want to talk. Y'all don't want to talk. Our dysfunction has become, our abnormalities has become normal because we've learned how to operate in dysfunction. And that dysfunction has become normality. Now, this is interesting. Look at number 4. I want y'all to read this together. 1, 2, 3, read. The Holy Ghost takes you from trying. I'm trying to do this. I'm trying to do that. I'm trying to do. Yeah, you trying to do it instead of allowing the Holy Ghost to do it. It's going to take you from trying to do it. And then watch this. You'll try so long till you become you become discouraged and then you give up. That's a tactic of your flesh. Who will be honest and say, I just gave up? You know why? Day Lewis, you know why? Y'all know why? Because you tried to do it yourself. And you cannot do it yourself. You're going to fail every time. You're going to stay. See, we want to keep the Holy Ghost, and I know I'm totally off script now because I know theologically, you don't say, man, he ain't referencing to the text. He ain't referencing to the text, but now y'all better hear me. I am referencing to the text. Everything that was read, I'm talking about right here. See why? Now, let me help you. He just gave me this. One of the problems is you're trying to limit the Holy Ghost just for church operation. The Holy Ghost is for your everyday life, too. Lord, see, let me, I'm going to help somebody. Let me show y'all how the Holy Ghost has operated. You didn't know what it was. You want to know why you made that turn to the left and you don't know, why did I turn this way? That was the Holy Ghost protecting you from something that you didn't even see. Wow. He says it's a protector. Right. It's protecting you from stuff that you don't even see. Man, I can't get out of this house. You ever know you were up ready on time and you just couldn't, something just kept happening, delay. I don't know, why can't I just leave? And next thing you know, you were delayed to find out that an accident or something happened that you would have been engaged in. And then let me take you this. Some of you all who are stressing, thank you, Holy Ghost, I hear you. Some of you all that are tripping, why are you going through what you're going through? Watch this. The Lord said, I'm allowing you to go, I don't know who this is for. I'm allowing you to go through what you're going through so I can manifest the Holy Ghost in you. I'm allowing you to encounter what you're encountering. I'm allowing you to encounter what you're encountering because I'm manifest. Because see, you've become so conditioned to operating yourself. He said, I got to show you that some stuff is bigger than you. I got to show you that this thing you can't understand, you can't comprehend, you don't have the answer. So I got to show you the Holy Ghost. Because if not, watch this, the Holy Ghost will be residing in us and we'll be doing nothing with it, but we'll be trying to operate in us. And that's what's been happening in a lot of situations. Number five. The Holy Ghost is a gift that was already given. Jesus gave himself to give you him. Thank you, Lord. It's already been. Now, what do you, a gift. What do you do with a gift? You receive it and you open it. When you open it, it'll open you. Oh, he just dropped this on me. Many of y'all have received the gift, but you ain't opened it. Many of you have received the gift, but you ain't opened it. So you got a gift that's been sitting under your tree for 50 years, wrapped up, tied up, ripped, good, nice bow, pretty wrapping, and you just sitting there looking at it. Woo, that gift. A gift will do you no good until you open it. I need somebody to release this into the atmosphere. Open your gift. Open the gift. Open the gift. Open the gift. Open that gift. It was given on the day of Pentecost as a gift. You don't have to work for it. You don't have to do all this extraordinary turn, go run around making Georgia 10 times, and you don't have to do none of that. The only thing you have to do is receive it and open it and just say, here I am. Here I am. Here I am. I'm presenting. Here I am. I'm opening that gift. Now let that gift come on. That's all. When is the last time you just sincerely just say, Lord, here I am. Here I am. Not conditional. Oh, I don't want to do that. No, here I am. Here I am. Uh-oh. Now, this is challenging. Number six. Now, this is going to hit some people in the throat. Many are confessing or confusing the Holy Ghost with other ghosts. That ain't Jesus. He said many. Now, this, I'm laying here. Laying before God, and he's speaking this stuff to me for the world. I'm like, really? He said, many are confusing the Holy Ghost with other ghosts. That ain't Jesus. A lot of this stuff that you see and thank the Holy Ghost, he said, that ain't me. That ain't me. Okay, I'm probably going to lose some Facebook friends on this one. Here we go. Tag team, now you dance. Right. Right. He said, listen, if you pay attention, there's a difference between the holy dance, the Holy Ghost in your feet to dance, and all of this other stuff. Oh, see, I got something then. I'm going to lose some friends on that one. He said, a lot of this stuff that you see ain't me. Right. I've never seen. So you mean to tell me, watch this. I'm going to show you how flesh has gotten into this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost, Lynn, you sitting back there. The Holy Ghost going to tell you, come out from back there and run all the way up here just to dance. You better preach that one. You can dance. The Holy Ghost will cause you to dance right where you are. Yes. It ain't going to make you, oh, let me run all the way up here and then stop dancing and watch somebody else. And then when they finish me, and then we high five each other. Yeah. I don't lost some friends on that. I already know. I'm going to get some inboxes on it. The Lord said, that's not me. That's not me. Okay, here's another thing. Satan has replicated tongues. Satan has replicated the spiritual gifts of tongues. Everything that you hear, blah, 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 is not the Holy Ghost. Oh, Lord, I'm losing folks. I feel it. Everything that you hear, blah, 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 and don't you, and watch this. I pray now, God, intensify our discernment for this dimension, that we'll be able to distinguish what is the Holy Ghost and what is not of the Holy Ghost, so that we won't be confused and tricked in thinking, oh, that's the, no, it ain't the Holy Ghost, honey. That ain't the Holy Ghost. That is the spirit of Antichrist on his operation. Because see, let me tell you what my prayer is. We're talking about the Holy Ghost. See, I want the Holy Ghost. And I need my people that's close to me to start meditating and fasting and praying with me on this one right here. That when people ride by 1985, they ain't even got to come into this building. That when they ride by 1985, a miracle will happen. When they write down Vine, Hardeman and Vineville Avenue, they ain't even got to turn into the parking lot. They just ride by and see this city sitting on the hill, and the Holy Ghost will overtake them. And while they're driving here, miracles will happen. Healing will, that's my prayer. I need some people that are lay prostrate, that are come with me, that said, come on, overseer, I'm right here with you. We ain't got time for all that other foolishness. Come on, overseer, I go with you to the throne. I go with you to that dimension, that watch with miracle signs and wonders that are happening. They could be down in Fountain Car Wash and somebody be like, whoa, what happened? I just got healed. It's the Holy Ghost. Right now, you're hearing me. See, we ain't told, this kind of preaching ain't happening now. That's what I'm talking about. Because see, now it's not about joining no church. It's not about, well, I ain't a member of that church. No. The moment that you walk in here, ain't nobody got to touch you. No one has to lay hands on you. Nobody got to speak to you. You are coming to a holy place. You are coming in the presence of a holy God, where the Holy Ghost is operating. And watch this. You will get your deliverance, and nobody even have to touch you. Satan dare not even peep his head in here, because the Holy Ghost would be in such operation. I felt that. Yeah. He said, it's already been given. I gave myself the gift to you. Oh, God. Many are confusing the Holy Ghost with. Now watch this. This gonna require, oh, God, number seven. Oh, God, number seven. He said total submergence. He said total submergence, huh? Take this phone right now. Get it the other word. Everybody say total submergence. Total submergence. That means the satanic kingdom is victorious. See what happens? The satanic kingdom is victorious in areas that the Holy Ghost hasn't taken over. Well, watch this. Wherever the Holy Ghost hasn't taken over, that's the area where the satanic kingdom it has taken over. That's the area where the satanic kingdom is has victory. But total submergence. Everybody say total submergence. Total submergence. That means every area is saturated. That means every area, it's the Holy Ghost. That means my mind, that means my eyes, that means my ears, that means my mouth, that means my everything, my heartbeat, everything is the Holy Ghost. Are y'all hearing me in here? I'm talking about the Holy Ghost taking so much power, taking total control of you. You'll be like Paul, the shadow. Even at your shadow, demons cried out. Even at his shadow, you didn't have to say a word. Just at the shadows, demons cried out. Everybody say the Holy Ghost. I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. Even when you go to work and that supervisor getting on your nerve, you ain't got to say a word. They'll come kneel before you and say, oh, they'll come, y'all didn't hear what I said. I say, they'll come kneel before you. They'll come kneel before you. And acknowledge, watch this, they ain't gonna acknowledge you. They're gonna acknowledge the Holy Ghost on the inside of you. They say, you know what? Because Satan, he's gonna kneel before Jesus. He's gonna kneel and say, you are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. And the Lord, he just told me, and you need to start practicing that now. Where devils would come kneel before you. Where devils would come kneel before you and acknowledge the Holy Ghost that's on the edge. I feel the power where the Holy Ghost would come kneel before, that cause Satan and demons to come kneel before you. Ooh. Ooh. Oh God. Stay with me, Tyler. Everybody say the Holy Ghost. Everybody say the Holy Ghost. Yeah, I'm talking about power. I'm talking about power. The same power, Elizabeth. The same power that spoke and said, let there be light over 3-4 million years ago. And light appeared. The same power that went to Lazarus' grave and told Lazarus, I ain't got to touch you. I don't have to lay hands on you. I command you to come forth. The power, watch this. You ain't got to speak. You ain't got to argue. You just speak that thing and it shall happen. I'm talking about that power of the Holy Ghost. If you want change in your situation, if you want healing in your body, tap into the Holy Ghost. And see, now you don't have to wait to get to the altar. You don't have to wait to get to church. You can be in your car. You can be at home. You can be washing dishes and the Holy Ghost will move right there. Matter of fact, some of y'all need to turn your homes into a spiritual temple. Some of you need to turn your homes because your homes are unholy. Your homes have become unclean. Your homes have become contaminated. You need to go through your house and command every demonic force. I don't matter how I got there, I command you, devil, leave my house. Leave my house. Rededicate your house back to the Lord. I'm talking to somebody here. I hear your Holy Ghost. I hear your Holy Ghost. I hear you. I hear your Holy Ghost. I hear your Holy Ghost. Oh God. Next point. Oh, watch this. He said this. I want y'all to hear this. He said, there are endless possibilities with the Holy Ghost. Let me say it again. He said that there are endless possibilities with the Holy Ghost. Let me say it again because y'all still didn't get that. He said there are endless possibilities with the Holy Ghost. He said, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Watch this. Oh, he said, there'll be no struggle. He said, watch this. There's endless possibilities. If you can imagine it, if you can see it, he said, there's endless possibilities. If you can see yourself healed, he said, there's endless possibilities. If you can see yourself delivered, he said, there's endless possibilities. If you can see yourself being elevated, he said, there's endless possibilities. You don't have to stay in the shape that you're in. You don't have to stay in that city. You don't have to stay in that position. He said, if you can see yourself out of it, there are endless. I come out of my shape. There are endless possibilities with the Holy Ghost. Ooh. Oh, I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. Speak Holy Ghost. Speak Holy Ghost. Here, next point. Speak Holy Ghost. Oh God. He said, ooh, the Holy Ghost is about to shock some people by using you. Oh God, y'all missed that. The Holy Ghost is about to shock some people by using you. Let me say it again. The Holy Ghost is about to shock some people. People that has been given up on. People that said it weren't gonna amount to anything. People that said, oh yeah, you in it now, you can't. God said, I'm about to shock some folks. I'm about to disturb some folks. Oh, they've been hating on you then. Oh, they ain't seen nothing now. Because what the Holy Ghost is about to do, because the Holy Ghost is taking control. control. The Holy Ghost has taken over you. What the Holy Ghost is about to do, you think you've been operating before. You ain't seen nothing yet, because God said, what I'm about to do in you, was it something on the inside, working on the outside, that's bringing about a change in your life? The Holy Ghost on the inside, working on the outside. I wish somebody shout change. Yeah. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. I'm talking about power. I'm talking about Holy Ghost power. I'm talking about Holy Ghost power. Oh, some of y'all, I thank you, Holy Ghost. He said, some of you got to come back to your first love and do that first works over again. He says, some got to come back and do thy first works over again. Ain't no shame. Come on, who'll go with me to the, I'll be the first one to go to this altar and say, God, I need a refilling. God, I need for you to do this thing. Who'll come with me to the altar? I'm not ashamed to say, God, I want a refilling. God, I need for you to do this thing. God, I need for you to do it, because we want to operate in the fullness of the Holy Ghost. God, refilling of the Holy Ghost, refilling of the Holy Ghost, refilling of the Holy Ghost. I rededicate my life to you. Refilling of the Holy Ghost, refilling of the Holy Ghost, miracle signs and wonders, activation. This morning, I give myself back to you. I rededicate myself back to you, that you will be pleased, that you will be honored in Jesus' name. I wish somebody wouldn't be ashamed to go to the altar and tell him, I want you, I want you, I want you all over me. On this day of Pentecost, on this day of Pentecost, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed of the gospel, woman of God. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. God, refill. Lord, refill. Lord, refill. Lord, refill us. Refill this place. Refill this ministry. Refill us with the Holy Ghost. Refill us with the Holy Ghost. Bring us back, God. Refill us, God. Refill us. Refill us. You have gifts. You have gifts. You have gifts. Come to this altar. Come to this altar, Excel. Come to this altar. Come to this altar. Come to this altar. Willie Hollins. Come to this altar. Come to this altar. Come to this altar. Lynn. Come to this altar. Come to this altar. Yeah, I'm calling out. Come to this altar. Come now. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Refill us, God. Refill us. 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 Do it, God. 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 Refill us. Refill us. We rededicate ourselves to you. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. It's on your exhale. It's on your breath. It's on your exhale. It's on you. It's on you. Now he said, I'm gonna get in you. He said, I'm gonna get in you. He said, I'm gonna get in you. 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 He said, I'm gonna get in you. 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 He said, I'm gonna get in you. I'm gonna get in you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I pray the prayer that the apostles prayed. I pray now you receive the, it's all over you. Look at the hands starting to sweat. It's all over you. It's all over you. It's all over you. I pray that you receive the gift. Everybody in this place, stand to your feet right now. Lord, engulf this place. Engulf this place. Engulf this place. Give us an outpouring and a refilling. Give us an outpouring and a refilling of the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost, of the Holy Ghost, of the Holy Ghost, yes. 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 Outpouring, refilling. Outpouring, he said, don't quench it this time. He said, don't quench it this time. Outpouring, refill. Outpouring, refill. Feel, feel, fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost, day of Pentecost, day of Pentecost, fire! Release healing in this house. I release healing in this house. Those of you that are tuned in, I release healing in your house through the Holy Ghost. It's still on you. I see it. It's still on you. I see it. Come here. Come here, Shea. I know we've gone over our time. TJ, if you got to sign off, go ahead and sign off. Lift your hands right there. Just lift your hands. Victoria, this is your sister standing behind her. Put your hands on her back. Ooh, come on, my shaky. Hey, my shoulder, baba, rapa, shake it. Namara, mama, shake it. Hura, baba, baba, shake it. Nama, who shake it in the name of Jesus. Fill her now, Lord. Fill her, fill her, fill her, fill her. For I see your hand on her. 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 I see your hand on her now. Now let her receive it. Just receive it. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it. Lay your hands on her belly. Receive it, 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 receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Receive it. Hey, hey, my shit. Oh, go. Go ahead. Matter of fact, go ahead and log off, TJ. Because something is happening in here.